What's up guys, this is Yasser. Welcome back to my channel. You're watching Yasser's Fit Frag, and today I'm going to talk about another four Athars from the brand Rasasi. So if you haven't watched my previous series on Al Haramain store Hyderabad, they give the option of decanting these sealed pack Athars, which are generally a little expensive. So in case you do not want to blind buy a full bottle, you can just ask for a decanted version of those Athars. They give you options of 3ml, 6ml, 12ml, however you like, and they give exact division of the total price of the full bottle. So I have four today from the brand Rasasi. All are decanted like these, okay, like these 3ml ones which are decanted. So in case you're interested in watching the decanting video, I will place them and you can check it out as to how exactly the full bottle looks like. And these four decanted Athars were provided in this beautiful little presentation box. They actually look nice, and this is where they sit. So this is the front and back. This is not official Rasasi box, it is their store presentation box. So in case you're buying a decanted Athars of any of their collection, they generally give it in this if you buy more than 2 to 3 Athars in one order. So in case you want to visit the store directly, you can definitely call them and visit the store. But if you're not residing in Hyderabad, you can definitely order them online and he will deliver it to your address. So let's start with number four. Coming in at number four is Rasasi Summer V. This is a decanted version again. The Summer V full bottle looks like this, which is from the brand Rasasi. But this is the decanted 3ml version, and this costs about 300 for a 3ml considering the full bottle price. So this to me is a little feminine in terms of the blending, because it opens up with a very candy type of orange note with a heavy dose of florals, sweet florals. So not something that I personally like, but there are people who love sweet floral kind of fragrances. So for those, I think this would be a good option, because this to me is a little too much on the sweeter side, very floral, very sweet on the candy orange note. So not something that I would enjoy wearing, but it is still a good fragrance in terms of the quality. In the late dry down, you would get sweet amber, sandalwood and musk. So that's the overall blend in this one, that is Rasasi Summer V. In terms of wearing, this will only suit for the winters, because it can get too cloying in the high summers if you wear it, because it is too sweet and floral. So I'm not sure if it would suit in the high summers, but definitely will suit during the cooler season, or if you're wearing it in air conditioned setup. Coming to performance, it projects easily about 2 hours, and it lasted a good 8 hours on my skin, so not bad. At number three is Rasasi Rabwa. This is again a decanted version. This is how the full bottle looks. Now this opens up with a nice orange and white floral note. In the late dry down, you would get a very nice creamy vanilla along with musk. The opening was not really impressive, but don't judge this by the opening. Give it some time. After 30 minutes, that beautiful vanilla comes in, and that is when the overall blend gets very appealing. That vanilla actually gives it a very creamy feel to the overall blend after 30 minutes, and then it starts giving an airy type of projection, and that is when it actually smells really good. So don't judge this in the opening at all, because the beauty starts after 30 minutes when the vanilla pops out. In the late dry down, which is like after 2 hours, you can feel that nice little soft cashmere wood. So it projects about 2 hours, and after which that cashmere wood starts coming up to give it that nice little soft woody base, and then the overall lasting is about 8 hours. But again, after 8 hours, the vanilla still sticks on, and it goes about 12 to 14 hours. So after 8 hours, you would not sense any of the blends that you sense in the opening. It is only that creamy vanilla which sticks on to your skin and goes about 12 to 14 hours. So that is Rasasi Rabwa. The 3ml costs about 300 change, around 310 or 320, excluding the shipping costs. So I'm not really counting the shipping costs here. So it depends on which city you live in. So that was at number three. Now coming in at number two is Ruh Al Tib. Now the original bottle of this looks like Oud Al Mithali. I've done a separate video on that as well. You can check it out. This is a totally different fragrance if you compare with that, though the bottle looks similar. This one opens up with a very strong grapefruit and pink rose note. Now though it has that pink rose note, it does not really smell feminine. And it will still suit for the high summers as well, because I don't think this type of blend will get cloying in the high summers. Because do not compare the rose in this to be a typical feminine kind of rose. It is very nicely covered with that strong grapefruit vibe, and that is why I feel it will definitely suit the summers as well. Now after the dry down, you would get a nice white lily note along with that little bit spiciness of geranium, and in the late dry down, which is after 2 to 3 hours, you would get a very nice sandalwood vibe. overall a beautiful fragrance, but I still prefer Oudal Mithali over this one because this is a little sweeter compared to Oudal Mithali, but not too sweet to make it super feminine. All of these are definitely unisex, but it depends on your personal taste again. So performance wise, projects about 2 hours and easily lasts about 8 hours on my skin, but on clothes it actually went about 10 hours plus. So that was Rasasi Ruh Al Tib. 3 ml cost about 300 again. Now coming in at number one, now this is my favorite from this lot in today's list, and that is Rasasi Wahami. Reason why it is favorite is because this is an exact oil version or attar version of Rasasi Shura. I would say it's about 95% similar to Rasasi Shura. Okay, that's the name, Rasasi Wahami. This is how the bottle looks like. But it is very, very close to Rasasi Shura. I think they just made a replica of that in the attar form. So those who do not like spray versions and still love the smell of Rasasi Shura, you can just go for this one because this is about 95% close. The difference of 5% is maybe because spray versions, they use a lot of other solvents. So that can make a slight difference, but otherwise they're very, very close. I was not able to detect that significant difference in the two because it was very close. Obviously the projection gets a little better on the perfume version, but otherwise does not mean that this does not perform. It easily projects 2 hours, but within the 2 feet boundary, and then it easily lasted about 8 to 10 hours on my skin. So that is Rasasi Wahami, my favorite from this list, because I love Shura as well when it comes to winters. So this will definitely suit for those who love Shura, and if you do not like the spray version, just go for this one. This is a ditto copy of that, I would say 90 to 95% easily. A beautiful blend of that tobacco and amber and a little bit of that tomato, raw tomato kind of mid note, beautiful blend. So that's about today's list. Thanks for watching again. Comment down in the comment section. See you next time soon. Keep sharing the videos. Cheers.